YouTube, Rook here from Rook Geek Goodness, my little channel web for all things geeky and cool, and welcome back to the channel, guys. Welcome back to the Funko review and unboxing video. First thing is first, I want to thank all my viewers and subscribers who still watch all my content, but if this is your very first video watching on my channel, I hope you can give this video a like at the bottom of the page and click that subscribe button, either the picture of my face or the little 8-bit icon in the corner. It will help this video go across the YouTube platform for other people looking for this type of content can find it. So what are we talking about in this Funko review and first impressions and unboxing? We're talking about the Texas Rattlesnake himself, Stone Cold Steve Austin. Probably one of the most popular superstars for WWE back in the 90s and probably to this day, extremely popular when him and The Rock had their battles. But Austin was awesome back in the days, back in what they call the Attitude Era. And this pop is really cool on the surface, but there's a lot of moving parts you may or may not know about this particular pop, which we'll talk about, specifically the cost, and it's missing something from the packaging, which you can see right here. That being said, let's talk about the breakdown. Very first thing we talk about in a breakdown segment is the packaging and presentation. This is your typical window box display for Funko. Let's break it down, all the moving parts here. We got right here, Pop WWE, the WWE logo right here, number 89 in the wave, a nice window box display of Stone Cold, a nice shot of him right here, holding the two titles he has in this pop. At the bottom, it does say here Stone Cold Steve Austin. But what's missing from this pop is the exclusivity of this pop, because as the thumbnail said, this is a 7-Eleven exclusive pop. Notice here, there's no 7-Eleven sticker on the packaging, which we'll talk about that shortly. Let's finish this design here, the packaging, and we'll talk about that missing sticker. Over here, you have a nice shot of what Stone Cold will look like out of packaging. Over here, it does say Stone Cold Steve Austin, number 89. And the back of the packaging here showcases all the characters that are available in that particular wave, as well as a really cool shot here of Stone Cold Steve Austin. But back to the packaging and that missing 7-Eleven sticker, which is a kind of an issue, I would say, with this pop, because you're expecting the 7-Eleven exclusivity sticker on the corner right here, much like the Rey Mysterio right here. The Rey Mysterio pop came out several years ago, which was a 7-Eleven exclusive. Different sort of buck, the older buck design. This really sports the new design of what Funko's doing. They're making their characters look more like people, not blocky bucks like they had back years ago for Funko. But again, I digress, the missing sticker. This looks to be an error, from what I did my research, an error by Funko's and 7-Eleven's part. You can request them to ship you the missing sticker. You need two pieces of information to do this. You have to go to basically the Funko's website, you go to the customer service, you have to include a shot of your proof of purchase and a shot of the pop itself, and they should, with no issues, so hopefully, ship you out a sticker. Unfortunately, I lost my receipt. I gave them a picture of my pop. I'm hoping I can get that sticker. I may or may not be able to get that sticker going forward, but this kind of makes up an issue where is this pop more valuable with the sticker or without the sticker? That I don't really know. I can't really draw a conclusion to that particular question, only because if they make this as a second round of pops with the sticker included, that would lead me to believe this one, which would be the first run of the Stone Cold Steve Austin pops, may be more valuable in the long-term collectible market. Another point we want to talk about is the price. This guy is extremely more expensive than your traditional pops. It has a price point of $20 US. If you compare it to, let's say, a shared exclusive or an exclusive pop for, let's say, New York Comic Con, San Diego Comic Con, Emerald City Comic Con, all those pops in this scale sport a $15 price point. This guy has a $20 price point. That's almost the same price point of a normal action figure from Marvel Legends, Star Wars Black Series. I don't like the price point being so high at $20. You get a point of articulation. I think they're taking this cost and spitting it back to the consumer, because probably retail licensing, it probably is so expensive to get this, to get the license. That's why they're putting that cost to the consumer. That's my thought. I want to kind of dig a little deeper in the breakdown segment where we get this guy out of packaging. With that being said, let's get Stone Cold. Stone Cold out of packaging to the breakdown segment. Alright guys, we have our Funko 7-Eleven exclusive Stone Cold Steve Austin out of packaging. And next thing we do, we take a pop out of packaging, we look at the paint and articulation. This is a really cool design, Stone Cold Steve Austin, showcasing two world title belts. First thing is first, let's talk about the belts he's holding if you're not familiar with these titles. This belt right here is the tag team title. This one in his other hand is the heavyweight championship, otherwise known as the Winged Eagle belt, which I'll put a picture up on the screen so you can see what that belt would look like. It's probably one of the more iconic belts for WWE. I love that particular belt. All fans of WWE really like that belt. It has a lot of history and a lot of prestige, very similar to the WCW Big Gold Belt, which of course is this title you can see on the screen right now. But I love the way they did with the Stone Cold Steve Austin pop. It doesn't look like it's a blocky figure. This is very similar to the WWE exclusive version, which he just had one title over one hand. It looks really, really cool, which would be this guy right here. This is the WWE exclusive version. This one right here, and put this right back here, is the, again, 7-Eleven exclusive version. So let's take a look and break him down really quickly here. He has the Austin 316 shirt on right here. He got his blue jeans. I assume this is when he had his knee pads, the knee braces on. It's kind of covered over by the shorts. I think those are going to be his medically graded knee pads he had, because he had bad knees because of the botched pile driver he took from Owen Hart, which shortened his career. If you're not familiar, you can look that up on YouTube. Kind of messed up what happened to him. One thing about this particular Stone Cold, he does not have the smoking skull on the back of his shirt. The Austin 316 usually would be on this side right here, but you'd have the smoking skull icon on the back. Why he doesn't have that, not quite sure. Of course, he is ball-headed like we've seen for Stone Cold. There is articulation. Head will spin 360 with no hindrance, no issues there. The belt is kind of cool here. It's kind of flapping here. There are straps that you basically would hook here and put it around your waist. That's why there's buckles right there, these snap points. And I think you can see the plates, yeah. You know, there would normally be plates right here on the side of the championship title, as well as the tag title on this shoulder right here. But really good look for Stone Cold Steve Austin. Love the way he looks. This design for him looks really, really good. Again, as I mentioned at the beginning of the breakdown, the biggest problems I have with this pop are twofold. One is the price. $20 for retail is unheard of for a Funko Pop in this scale. If it was a bigger scale, let's say 6-inch, or it was a multi-pack, or a 10-inch pop, then you could have a different price point. But a $20 standard size pop, even being exclusive, is too high in my personal opinion. At $5 more, even $5 to me, is asking a little bit much for the Funko collector. This is basically, you're going to be a Funko collector looking for this product. You're going to be a scalper, which will try to flip it online for even more money. Or you may be, let's say you're a fan of wrestling, you might want it because you're a wrestling fan. That's another reason why you want to purchase this pop. Your standard consumer probably would not buy this guy, in my personal opinion. But if you're someone who, again, is a collector, wrestling fan, or a flipper, that's why you're probably going to purchase this pop. Love the way he looks. I think Funko nailed the design for Stone Cold here. I just think the price tag at $20 US is too much money, because you could buy an action figure almost for that price. Maybe normal action figures nowadays are $22 to $24 US. But coming in at $20 plus tax in most states is really too much money. This should have been a $15 pop at the most. On the secondary market, let's say you're looking at your Amazon or specifically eBay, you're probably spending at least $30 to $40. I've heard allegations, this thing even going for more money, $50, $60. Don't spend that money, guys. I would not spend, personally speaking, more than $30 for the Stone Cold Steve Austin. Again, the biggest other concern besides the price is the missing sticker. Is it worth your time and effort to contact Funko, provide that proof of purchase, a photocopy or an image of this particular pop in your collection to get that forgotten and missed sticker, that 7-Eleven sticker? Is it worth your while to pick this up? I don't know. If they make a second wave of these figures, they'll probably put the stickers on the package, in my thought. That's why you may or may not want to pick the sticker up. If they make a second round of them, then don't buy the sticker. If they don't make one run of these, then maybe pick the sticker up to put it on your box. But if they make a second round, absolutely, I don't think you should put the sticker on it, because that would give you the distinction between the first edition and, in this case, a second run or second edition of that Funko Pop. That's my personal opinion. But all things considered, it's still an awesome pop. I like what they did with Stone Cold here. If you're a fan, a collector of wrestling memorabilia, if you're a fan of Stone Cold, absolutely pick this guy up for your collection. And with that being said, let's go to final thoughts and wrap up this video. Alright guys, final thoughts on the Funko WWE exclusive 7-Eleven version of Stone Cold Steve Austin, the Texas Rattlesnake, probably the most important wrestler in the 90s for the Attitude Era. Should you spend your money and pick this guy up? As I mentioned in the breakdown segment, if you're a fan of wrestling, if you're a fan of Stone Cold, even if you like this design, this is something you probably should pick up. The price point is a bit steep at $20 US. I mentioned that before several times in the video. I don't think this is a $20 pop. Personally speaking, it is not a shared exclusive. It is not a convention exclusive. It is a 7-Eleven exclusive. price point of $20 US, which I think they pushed that price to the consumer because of the licensing cost. That's why I think it's $20, not your typical budget $15 for, let's say, New York Comic Con, San Diego Comic Con, Emerald City Comic Con, Pops, which are usually $15 price points in this size scale. $20 is a bit much. I mentioned before, you could buy an action figure for that. Also, the biggest issue, we're missing that sticker, that 7-Eleven exclusive sticker, which we don't have on this pop. Should you pick it up? Should you contact Funko? That's up to you. I tried on my part. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to get the sticker. I'm hoping they'll send one to me, but if they do or don't, I'm not too worried about it. If they make a second wave of these pops, which have the sticker included, the ones without the sticker, in my personal opinion, probably worth more money on the secondary market as a collectible. That's what I personally think. And probably the last point you may want to ask yourself, should you display him out of packaging? I think this guy should be displayed out of packaging, mainly because of the double titles. Having the two belts here is a really cool thing they did with Stone Cold here. Not many times he held two belts simultaneously, and most of the time you don't see pops that have two belts associated with their pop. Maybe if they make a Becky Lynch when she was two belt Becky Lynch, maybe they'll do something along those lines. But this is kind of cool. I think this should be a displayed pop. Take him out of packaging. I like sometimes leaving stuff in package on card, sometimes like taking stuff off card. That's up to you with your collectibles. I think he'd look much better off of package. So I think that's the way I'm going to display my Stone Cold Steve Austin. And I hope you do like this video review of the Texas Rattlesnake himself. Please click that like button by my page. Click the subscribe button, which is a picture of my face. When you subscribe, you'll click the bell icon to notify my latest videos. And of course, last but not least, click Windows over here to watch more of my content. Take care, guys. I'll see you next video. And bye-bye. Stone Cold! Stone Cold!